morning, everybody. We will see the details about Nayaka and Nayika Bhed given by sage Bharata. Bharata's treatment of dramatic characters appears to employ the following considerations. The one, the choice of the principal characters, the hero and heroine, is determined by the consideration of the goal set by the dramatic plot. The hero is expected to be worthy particular purushartha he is supposed to achieve. The theory therefore speaks of the social status and rank of the hero and certain innate qualities and acquired qualifications the hero should possess. The heroine is similarly expected to be worthy of the hero from social and religious point of view and also in consideration of her innate qualities. The theme of love receives prominence in dramatic practice. Psychologically, this is quite natural. A theme of love has always the greatest popular appeal. In the context of Sringara, therefore, men and women are particularly treated for their qualities and helpfulness, and the hero and the heroine are classified into special categories so as to suggest their approach to love and their conditions of love. The third one, the another character in drama generally fall into two ranks, the partisans of the hero and those that belongs to the opposite camp. Their characteristics are described by the consideration as well as by their social rank and status. The fourth one, there appears to be a certain kind of idealism in treating the characters, especially the principal ones. It must be due to the idea of purushartha and the importance of healthy instruction expected from dharma that the characters are treated as types rather than as individuals. The general tendency is to set ideal character as perfect as humanity possible before the spectators, both for their emotional enjoyment as well as for their mental and spiritual uplift. Yet, as air of realism breaches through the characters, this is particularly seen in their social characterization, their relationship, the level of their culture, the kind of spoken speech they use, which is as much a reflection of their social rank as it may be of the dramatic convention. The elaborate instruction that the Natya Shastra provides in listing correct social address and vocalities in mutual conversation of character and the suggestion regarding the dramatic names of minor characters certainly reflects the prevailing social ethos. Its recognition by the dramatic theory is an awareness of contemporary realism, an awareness of human nature as such as certainty, certainly to be seen in the theory. At the same time, dramatic necessity is more compelling, so the theory looks at characters as instruments of some worthy endeavor and its fulfillment and sets down their qualities and qualifications, allowing tiny scope for the expected turns and twists of human nature. This may be the reason why the characters in Sanskrit drama generally appears to be stereotyped, and it is only the great and inspired dramatists that reveal to us the unexpected humanity, compassion, the depth and the weakness as well as the weakness and nobility of human nature in their characterization. Men and women generally fall into three classes. The Uttama, or the exalted and noble, are the well-versed in various branches of knowledge and in a variety of arts and skills. They have a full control over their body, mind and senses. They are courteous and high-minded. Firmness is their virtue. They are ready to make any sacrifice and are a protection to the frightened or the poor. Seriousness, profundity and magnanimity characterize their disposition. Men and women of the middling class, that is Madhyama Prakriti, are equally proficient in sciences and arts and are clever in judging the pulse of social attitudes and behavior. Practical knowledge of the ways of the world bestows a sweetness on their speech and action. The low, that is Adhama, are characterized by rough speech, bad character and spirit. Limited intelligence, they are prone to eager and assault. Wicked and vengeful, ungrateful, insolent to talk, quarrelsome, addicted to sensual pleasures, covetous of wealth and beyond any scrupule. Women also fall into such class. Generally speaking, the enonch all kind of servants and messengers, shakara, vita, etc., belongs to the low caste or low class in the context of drama. Nayaka. Bharata visualizes four kinds of nayikas, which belongs to the high and middle classes. Dhirodhata, represented by the god or celestial characters. Dhira Lalita, in which category come the king? Dhirodhata, represented by Senapati and Amatya. Dhira Prashanta, represented by Brahmins and merchants. These four are the classifications of Bharata, is firmly established in letter theory. Bharata also has described the qualities to be expected in kings and as the most important dramatic type, Nataka adopts a king hero. These become the qualities of Nayaka, the leader of the principal dramatic action as well. Later theories dilate on these qualities of a dramatic hero. The theory suggests another angle of classifying the heroes, the angle or the contest of love, implying the attitude and behavior of the hero in regard to the matters of love. Bhava Prakashana mentions four kinds, that is Anukula, Dakshina, Shatha and Drushta. Then comes the Naika. Applying the general threefold classifications, Bharata describes the Uttama Prakriti Pramada to be of a soft nature, unimpetuous, speaking always with a smile, kindly in disposition, diligent in her obedience to elders, shy, modest, endowed with the natural qualities of loveliness, sweetness to all people, but also possessed of seriousness, depth and fortitude. The Madhyama in Prakriti, woman, possesses most of these qualities in lesser proportion and has some minor faults too. The Adhama Prakriti woman is like the low category of man and shares their traits. Speaking of Nayika, Bharata says that the heroine may be a celestial woman, a princess or royal queen, a woman of a noble family or a courtesan. The celestial and royal heroines are expected to be endowed with all the desirable qualities and will be of udatta prakriti. An exalted type of a woman may be herself gracious and trained in arts, full of fortitude and capable of confidence or secrecy. Such traits may be expected in a girl from noble family. A courtesan and other woman trained in arts and era, if will naturally be full of grace and charm, the worthy of sharing confidences. Bharata contemplates high and middling and low grades among the women and speaks of different kinds of women that are associated with a royal hero. Mahadevi is the crowned queen devoted to her royal husband, acting always in his interest and in that of the harem. She is usually a mature woman capable of anger but free from natural jealousy and willing to share happiness or sorrow with her husband. The other queens not crowned, having high virtues but lacking of superior polish, are Devi. They are proud, jealous of the love of their royal husband and therefore entering into rivalry with their competitors in love. Swamini are usually daughters of ministers, army chiefs and other royal servants who may not possess high honor but who have won the king's favor by their natural qualities, character and beauty. Sthapita are those women who by their youth and beauty have won the king's mind and are maintained by the king. They would always dress to perfection, though capable of harshness, jealousy and cruelty. They are adept in judging and worms of their royal masters, ready to please him, and are extremely clever in the art of love. The Bhogini is that type belonging to high lineage and blameless a character, which receives worship and honor by its own qualities. These women are soft, never rash, a little detached, forbearing, and worthy of confidences. Besides these women, the royal harem will have different kinds of maids, guards, dancers, old ladies and so on. Vasaka Sajja is a Naika who waits in a proper abode, fully decorating herself for a union with her lover and for the pleasure of love. This is a first type of Ashtanaika, which is known as Vasaka Sajja. The second one is Virahotkanthita. This is a Naika whose lover fails to visit her due to his preoccupation with diverse affairs of business and who consequently is afflicted with misery by the absence of her lover. The third one is Swadhina Bhartruka. She is the one whose lover sticks to her, bound by the relish and pleasure of love, and who therefore has attained the quality of profound joy and pride in her excellent good fortune. The next one is Kalahantarita. She is a Naika whose lover refuses to see her, estranged by jealousy and quarrel, and who is in a state of fuming but helpless indignation. Khandita. She is a Naika whose lover is unable to come to her, probably on account of his attraction for another woman, and who therefore is in a sorrowful state by his non-arrival. Vipralabdha is a betrayed Naika whose lover fails to visit her despite the message he had sent with a duti, or even though he had fixed an appointment with her. Proshita Bhartruka is one whose husband and lover has gone away on a journey or to execute various missions, and who is now neglecting the care of her hair, keeping them together in a single braid and loose at the ends. The last one is Abhisarika, is a bold Nayika who, hit by love or intoxication, discards the sense of shame or modesty and proceeds to meet her lover. Apart from the principal characters like the hero and the heroine, the other persons who are somehow associated with dramatic action and make a stage appearance in secondary, minor or negligible roles are mentioned in theory. Grouped about the hero and heroine, these dramatic characters are considered in the three contexts of dharma, artha and kama, in which matters they conceal and assist a royal hero. Bhava Prakashana describes them, therefore, under the three heads of dharma, sachiva, artha sachiva and kama sachiva. The first one is dharma sachiva. Rishis or a priest who is an expert in conducting rituals and sacrifices, and purohita or a king's official or family priest, are the two important associates in this field. Bharata describes the general qualities of the king's religious counselor as follows. Coming from high and noble families, endowed with splendid intellect, wise in the knowledge of many sciences, affectionate, incapable of being enticed by the king's opponents, ever alert and never blundering, native and patriotic, free from greed, properly trained and modest, pure in thought and conduct, and above all, deeply religious, is called a dharma sachiv. Artha sachiv. Artha, in connection with a royal hero, denotes polity and economy of the state, the prosperity which results from the practice of a correct and wise administrative policy. In this field, the king's mantras and ministers would probably take the pride of place. Bharata expects a minister to have the following qualities: endowed with superior intellect and a high sense of religious morality, expert in political science, never lazy or indolent, a pleasant talker, highly skillful in depicting the weak points of others and of the opponent, and fully equipped to take advantage of them, possessing an excellent knowledge about organizing military campaigns at correct times and seasons, clever and skillful in interpreting the precepts of political and administrative theory, having a noble lineage and very much devoted to his master, a one man who has an expert knowledge of the proper time and place for commencing and executing a significant mission. From the Natya Shastra and from the classical plays themselves, we are acquainted with some other characters that serve in the royal harem and are occasionally introduced in dramatic actions. Perhaps the most important of this is Kanchuki or Kanchukiya, the royal chamberlain, so called probably because he wears a long robe as a uniform of his office. He and Varsavara are said by Bharata to be employed in the harem and given the charge of looking after the young girls and princes. They wield authority in the royal harem and attend on the king and queen in their daily routine. They are carriers of news concerning everything that takes place in the harem. They enjoy confidence of their masters, so that Queen may give them duty even in the apartment of her royal husband. They are well trained and modest. They never give themselves high airs. By nature, they are free from faults. They are either important or effeminate, or at least not sex-minded at all. The Kanchuki is usually a Brahmin, very old, and possesses high skill required for the execution of the trusted and confidential duties. The Sanskrit drama often shows the Kanchuki grieving over his old age and complaining that the big cane staff that he first took in his hand as a mark of his authority when he joined the Antapura as a young person has now become, with advising years, his chief means of physical support in his movements in the royal harem. There are a number of maids and female servants, that are Paricharika, employed in the harem. One who continuously figures in the Sanskrit drama as the king hero's attendant is the Pratihari. Bharata says that her principal duty is to inform the king about all happenings concerned with the political matters of war and peace and other matters which arise out of social dealings and religious or cultural connections. In Sanskrit drama, the Pratihari appears as a guard of the entrance to the royal chamber. Whether in a palace or outside in a temporary camp, she reports and announces all the arrivals to the king, delivers and carries messages, and remains ever alert at the post at the entrance gate. Another character for the royal harem and well known is Shakara. Bharata mentions Shakara mainly as a forest tribe of low caste and refers to Shakara Bhasa, the particular dialect they speak. The third one is Kama Sachiva. In the context of love matters, the associates of the hero, according to the theorists, are Prithamartha, who is a path, Chanakya, Vita, Vidushaka, and a lower level still Seta, maids and the female companions who have been taken into confidence. Prithamartha is regarded as a Patakanayaka, the hero of the subplot, or Upanayaka, a secondary hero. He is just a little inferior to the hero so far as qualities and accomplishments are concerned. He is a camp follower of the hero, his bosom friend and companion, and for all practical purposes the equal of the hero, or only next to him. A fine example of a pure Pataka or Upanayaka is to be found in the character of Makaranda in the Malati Madhava, who displays touching devotion to his friend, the hero Madhava, and a brilliant heroic qualities as well, worthy of a true hero. Vita is technically described as Ekavidya, that is proficient in one of the fine arts, music, dance or poetry. The Vita is also exceptionally gifted in the arts of love. The impressions that we get about the Vita from the classical plays, that of an art-minded romantic and a bohemian young man whose company is prized by courtesans and by men who love to be near them. He is the hero of the Bhana type drama, which provides interesting pictures of his romantic escapades, his love intrigues, his fine culture and wit, and his bohemian character. Vidushaka really appears in four roles. As Bharata says, in association with the four kinds of heroes described in theory. Attached to the Dhirodhata celestial hero, the Vidushaka will be an ascetic or a muni, like Narada, for example. As a companion of a Dhira Lalita, a royal hero, the Vidushaka is a Brahmin. With a Dhirodhata minister or army chief, he will be a royal servant. And with a Dhira Prashanta, merchant or a Brahmin. Perceptor, the Vidushak will appear in the role of a pupil. As we find in a Prahasana like the Bhagavad-Jugiya. Since the surviving dramatic patterns are mostly Natakas, with royal heroes and late Prahasanas, the Dvija and Shishya types of Vidushaka only are generally familiar to us, and the Lingi and Rajajivi types are missed. Some later Therapists do mention the four types following Bharata, but the theory is rather based in favor of the Brahmin Vidushaka, which is the most common type used in Sanskrit dramas. The figure of the Brahman Vidushaka is quite familiar from the classical plays, as is his typical and in the latter period rather state the stereotyped humor. Being a companion or sakha of the royal hero, the Vidushaka enjoys a certain freedom in his verbal sallies, and often appears as a comic critic of human behavior, and particularly of the behavior of the royal hero and his harem in the contest of love. He is supposed to assist the hero in his love affair, that he does, but the dramatists have also used him in different roles. Seta is a servant who by position and as a dramatic character is low. But as Rasa Sutra points out, a Seta like Kalahamsa in the Malati Madhava can play a very useful role in establishing a link between the hero and the heroine. It is usually a carrier of messages, but this low character may also rise to the noble level of humanity by the utterly honest and selfless act, as exemplified by Shakara Seta when he jumps down from the terrace in his shackles in order to save the life of Charudatta. These associates of the hero in love are treated as high, low and middling according to their qualities and probably the dramatic roles they are supposed to play. Generally, the Prithamartha belongs to the Uttama class, Shakara and Set to the Adhama class. Sahitya Darpan regards Vidushaka and Vita as characters of the middling rank, but in the context of drama, the Vidushaka and Vita in Bhana are considered to be Nicha Patras. Some fine examples of the best kind of Duti Karma of helping the heroine will be found in the roles played by Kamandaki in the Malati Madhava, Pandita Kaushiki and Bakulavati, Bakulavakalika in the Malavikagni Mitra, and unconsciously by Vasanti in Uttara Ramacharitra. Bhava Prakasha adds a few types to the list of Dasharupaka as a woman who is skillful in entertaining by telling stories and anecdotes. Parivrajika plays this role in Malavikarni Mitra when Queen Dharini is injured and convulsing. Young unmarried girls and prince princesses, female heretics, a professional actresses or dancer, Rangopajivini, and a woman who arranges spectacular shows for entertainment. Bhava Prakashana recommends that messages may not be entrusted to female messengers who are poor or rich, who are too clever or very stupid. The qualities of a good messenger, according to Bhava Prakasha, are a perfect awareness of time and place, sweetness of speech, fine culture and polish, mature understanding and skill in providing encouragement, ability to guard a secret and a counsel, faithfulness and word perfection in delivering messages. Female messengers are generally employed to contact the men in the first affairs of love and to reconcile the lovers separated from each other due to pride, quarrel and estrangement. A duti may usefully contact a man during a festival, a night stroll, in a garden, in the house of an acquaintance or that of a female friend, or in the house of the nurse, or in a deserted house, under the pretext of inviting him or visiting him during a supposed illness, and so on. So these are the types we have seen of duti, that is the supportive of naika, and vidushaka, that is the supportive of nayaka.